I'm Susan from Tarjac. You may know us as the source for the best camo for your guns and bows, but we do so much more. Our custom work with automotive parts can transform any vehicle, our ATVs, sleds, four-wheelers, motorcycles. We've received national recognition for our work with Orange County Choppers, and we are most proud of our partnership with the Future Servicemen by providing customized helmets for the Army-Navy game. From the national stage to your favorite hunting ground, it's Tarjac.
Coming up on this week's CNY Business Connection, we'll begin the season's tax tips on ways you can best finance the purchase of a business, plus the latest in Business Connection classifieds, a look at job listings from around the area. Our legal tip will tell you the things you need to keep in mind when buying or selling a business, and this week's tip from Prendismo.com will stress the importance of your personal network in your business life. And we'll begin with this week's tax tip from Jerry Harrison Financial Services.
Many small business owners are finding themselves needing a business loan just as banks and credit unions are more reluctant to lend money to small businesses. To obtain that big bank loan, you need to make yourself credit worthy. Take a look at your personal credit report to make sure everything is in order there. Correct any mistakes the report contains. Make sure your business and personal financial statements are accurate. The financials need to have correct numbers and the numbers need to be in the right places. Considering having an accountant look at your financial statements before showing them to a lender. If traditional bank financing is not going to work for you, you need to look at alternatives. Is there a credit card that has a low interest rate that a balance can be carried on for a period of time? Are there investments or equipment that can be used as collateral to obtain a secured loan? Can you use an accounts receivable factoring loan as an option? Is there cash value to a life insurance policy that can be borrowed against? Another option is to approach a family member or friend that has some cash in the bank. Currently, most banks are paying less than 1% on money deposited in the bank. It might be a good investment for that family member or friend to get 6% or more interest from you. Make it legal and formal by having loan documents drawn up and a set repayment schedule. If there is no family member or friend, ask business associates, your accountant, or your attorney if they know individuals willing to lend money. There are individuals out there who consider this a good investment opportunity and will lend money if they believe in the person and or the business and they are a good risk. With this private financing, the interest rate will be higher than the rate paid to a traditional lender. This is because you are considered a higher risk. While it is not an ideal situation, finding financing wherever you can and at whatever interest rate you can may be a necessity. Make sure that loan document does not contain a prepayment clause and that you pay the loan off early if it becomes financially possible to do so. This is your tip of the week from Jerry Harrison at Jerry Harrison Financial Services. Check out our website at jerryharrison.com or call us for more information at 729-4144 to schedule an appointment.
We hope you enjoyed that. Time now for a look at Business Connection Classifieds, a look at the latest job postings from around the area.
In collaboration with the Rural Health Network of South Central New York, AVRE will be interviewing candidates for a low vision clinic access specialist. This position will connect persons with sustained vision loss to the Low Vision Center at AVRE and work with area eye care practices to integrate low vision services into standard eye care treatment for such persons. They will also build bridges with the eye care community, facilitate referrals, and create patient awareness and demand through educating collateral professionals and eye care office staff, direct-to-consumer presentations, and related activities. For more information and to apply online, visit the RHSC website and view AmeriCorps positions.
The Association for Visual Rehabilitation and Employment is looking for a manager of new business opportunities. This person would be responsible for identifying new AVRE products and services which have the potential to grow employment opportunities for people who are blind or visually impaired. Products and/or services identified must enhance both the mission and profitability of AVRE. The position has a focus on enhancing federal and state government business, but commercial opportunity development is also expected. Some business travel will be necessary to perform the essential functions of the position. Please send your resume to Kevin Berger's attention at AVRE, 174 Court Street, Binghamton, New York, 13901. You can fax your resume to Kevin at 607-771-8045 or email kberger@avreus.org.
As business grows, AVRE continues to create good jobs for legally blind individuals in various manufacturing, assembly, and packaging departments. These positions range from entry-level assembly and manufacturing to machine operators. AVRE offers competitive wages and benefits. Interested legally blind individuals should contact Kevin Berger, Accounting and Human Resources Manager, at 607-724-2428 or email him at avreinfo@avreus.org.
And for more on those job postings, you can go to bizconnecttv.com/jobs and follow us on Twitter at bizconnecttv. We'll take a break, but when we come back, buying and selling a business, some tips you need to look out for from the law offices of John G. Dowd, plus why tapping into your personal network is critical for business success.
I'm Norm Poulton. I've published the Central New York Business Journal for 25 years. Our success is based on the fact that we know only one audience, owners and managers of businesses in Central New York. We publish stories for them, we don't offer sound bites, and we always source our information. Maybe technology's changed since I started publishing 25 years ago, but not our mission. You can always rely on the Central New York Business Journal providing your business news.
Make your company's job opportunities stand out and get seen. The Binghamton Business Connection and BizConnectTV.com have created the area's first video job posting service. Don't hope a few words of text will get you the local candidate you want. Get your opportunity seen on the Binghamton Business Connection TV show and BizConnectTV.com/jobs. For an inexpensive multimedia and visual way to showcase your job openings, call 239-0199, email bizconnecttv@gmail.com, and watch the Binghamton Business Connection on My8.
Welcome back. Buying or selling a business can provide terrific opportunity, but also some pitfalls. What do you need to look out for? Here are some tips from the law offices of John G. Dowd.
Hello, I'm John Dowd with the law offices of John G. Dowd, and we're here today to talk about buying and selling a business. There are a number of ways you can structure the transaction. You can do it as an asset purchase agreement. If it's a corporation, you can buy the stock of that entity. If it's a limited liability company, you could buy the membership of the LLC. Other options are to do a like-kind exchange. Sometimes people will buy the stock but make a tax election to treat it as an asset purchase agreement. And there are several tax advantages to doing it in that manner. Tax implications require a good tax lawyer, CPA, or both. Surprisingly, if you model the sale of the business multiple ways as a potential buyer, one model usually jumps out as the best for both buyer and seller. Purchase price negotiations can be resolved in numerous ways. If the parties are far apart, perhaps an earnout is the answer. A buyer does not want to buy a pig in a poke, so if you base the purchase price on the post-closing earnings, that's a way for both the buyer and seller to meet their expectations. Allocation of purchase price can make or break a deal. The components typically are goodwill, covenants not to compete, consulting agreements, or employment agreements. If the buyer is a group of individuals, they will need to have a shareholder agreement, a buy-sell agreement, or an operating agreement that covers the ownership and owner departure issues. A few things that buyers don't typically think about are checking the workers' compensation rates and the unemployment insurance benefit rating of the target business. Pension liability issues is another hot button. Prepaid services that need to be fulfilled or you may lose the contract or the client are another issue. Employee sick leave, vacation time, credit for years of service are all items that have to be taken into consideration when you get into the details of buying a business. Remember, the more you plan, the more you save. The more you save, the more you keep. Thank you for watching this tip of the week from the offices of John Dowd.
Our thanks to John for that. Time now to turn things over to our friends at Prendismo.com, partnering with Entrepreneurs for Success. And this week's bit of business wisdom from someone who has lived it, why tapping into your personal network is critical for business success.
Your network is critical because the longer you stay in your career, the sooner you're going to see that it is such a small, small circle of people in that particular industry. So you definitely never want to burn bridges. There's just really no reason to go out on a bad note. Even if you're leaving a job or you're leaving a company and you know your coworkers are disappointed or they really want you to stay, you know, try your best to stay, you know, stay connected all the way through. Don't just kind of check out on your work and, you know, leave things a mess. Stay committed all the way through till your last day. And, you know, go around to the people that you worked with and let them know that you had a good time working with them while you were there. And, you know, see what you can do to end things on a good note. Another thing about networks, having gone back to get a second degree, one of the best things about having an MBA from Columbia Business School is the network that I have. No matter where I go, if somebody sees that I went to Columbia Business School and they are an alum as well, it's automatically a point to talk about. And it can open up a lot of opportunities and a lot of doors because it's a common ground. Your network really becomes the way that you want to find jobs as you get deeper in your career. When you first start out, you are kind of passively looking for a job. There are jobs out there. And you apply for them, and those are the opportunities that you have. When you get further along in the career, what you really want to be able to do is you want to create opportunities for yourself, and one way to create opportunities is to have a strong and deep network in your industry, because these people can they can vouch for you, they can alert you to opportunities, or you can go to them and you can say, I'm really looking for something like this, do you know of anything like that? And that is how you start to create opportunities for yourself when you're further along in your career.
And that does it for this episode of the CNY Business Connection. Thank you very much for joining us. Until next time, I'm Jason Weinstein. Have a good one.
Make your company's job opportunities stand out and get seen. The Binghamton Business Connection and BizConnectTV.com have created the area's first video job posting service. Don't hope a few words of text will get you the local candidates you want. Get your opportunities seen on the Binghamton Business Connection TV show and BizConnectTV.com/jobs. For an inexpensive multimedia and visual way to showcase your job openings, call 239-0199, email BizConnectTV@gmail.com, and watch the Binghamton Business Connection on My8.